Hi, and welcome to our video of Westerham Geen, as well as a look at Quebec House. Westerham sits in the northwest corner of the county of Kent, between junctions 5 and 6 of the M25, London's orbital motorway. We'll be starting our journey in the east of town at the Quebec House, next to the town's car park. We will wander to Westerham Green, through the Market Square, along the High Street, onwards towards the Long Pond at the western edge of town. So without further ado, let's get started at Quebec House. And this was the childhood home of Major General James Wolfe, victor of the Battle of Quebec in 1759. It was his home from birth until the age of around 11 years, when the family moved to Greenwich. The house was originally known as Spears, and renamed later after Wolfe's victory. The exterior dates from the mid-17th century, but the interior is said to be from the early 16th century, possibly as early as 1501. The property is maintained by the National Trust, and I'll pop a link in the description to their site so you can get more details of access and opening times. The house is decorated as it may have been in the 17th century, with additional mementos remembering the life of James Wolfe, the son of a distinguished general, probably schooled from an early age to follow in his father's footsteps. So who is Major General James Wolfe? And I am surprised he is not as well known as Lord Nelson or the Duke of Wellington. Maybe history hasn't been kind to him. He became a volunteer in his father's regiment at the tender age of 13. Later seen in action in the War of Austrian Succession, Flanders and in Scotland, where he took part in the campaigns to restore order after the Jacobite rebellions of 1745. In 1747 he returned to Europe and the War of Austrian Succession. It was the Peace Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle, also known as the Treaty of Aachen in 1748, that will put the brakes on his blooming military career. Hang on. We've been to the Peace Hall in Aachen, where that treaty was signed. But that's another video and another story. Major General James Wolfe will best be remembered for his victory at the Battle of Quebec in 1759, which was his last battle. On our visit, due to COVID, the house wasn't fully open, but that doesn't mean the end of the story. I wander around the house and its beautifully maintained gardens lead you to the coach house. Here you'll find a further exhibition on James Wolfe and Quebec House. By 1754 we were at war again, this time with France, and by 1758 Wolfe had been sent to modern day Canada. His victory on the Plains of Abraham led to the capture of Montreal, ending French control in the region. However, Wolfe was shot and killed by musket fire on the battlefield. In 2010 we visited Quebec City and the Plains of Abraham, overlooking the St. Lawrence River. We also saw the memorial, placed at the spot he is said to have fell. His body was returned to Britain and he was later rested in his family vault in St. Alfred's Church, Greenwich, which is coincidentally where Janice's parents married some 200 and a bit years later. Within St. Alfred's, you'll find a brass plaque, noting the place his body was laid to rest at the tender age of 32. And if you wander to the Royal Observatory in Greenwich Park, the statue next to it, overlooking Canada Tower and Canary Wharf, is that of James Wolfe. Now let's explore Westerham. It sits on the busy A25 trunk road, and we're just over half a mile south of the M25. It's filled with historic buildings, like the 18th century Grosvenor House. We have the Wolfe Cottages, and then there's the Breeches, the last home of Alice Hargreaves, the inspiration for Alice in Wonderland. And then there's Westerham Green, which in my road trip video I jokingly referred to as the Village Green, and that's because Westerham feels like a village to the outsider. Okay, with a busy road running through it, but still a village. And then there's the statue to Sir Winston Churchill, who lived nearby at Chartwell. Did you catch our video on that? I'll add a link at the end. Westerham Geen is a beautiful place to visit, with great little shops, a tea room, and the Grasshopper on the green. Don't ask, but it would have been rude not to. You'll also find a statue to Major General James Wolfe on the green. And now we've reached Market Square. Okay, I know it's not what you're expecting, but it still has some fine shops. Here you'll find the King's Arms and the Georgian Dragon. I'm hoping the George keeps pulling pints. There's plenty of places to get fed and watered in Westerham, with a wide choice available for all tastes. And one we must try on our next visit is Napoli. It looks so traditional. But then there's also a French brasserie and a lorry that's going to park in front of it to make its delivery. We're now officially in the High Street, and there's still plenty to see as we continue to explore Westerham. I really hope you like what we put together here. If you do, please click on that like button. It really helps. And why not subscribe too, to follow us on our travels. And now we find ourselves in Lodge Lane, with these cottages dating back to the 16th century. And the path leads to Squirrey's Lodge, which dates from the 13th century, but the exterior is much later, the 17th century. In fact, Squirrey's is a name synonymous with Westerham, and a history dating back to at least the 13th century. Now let's continue along the High Street. Westerham sits at the northern edge of the Weald of Kent, but you knew that because you called our Westerham and Weald of Kent road trip, didn't you? You didn't. I'll add it as a link at the end too. In short, Westerham makes a great base to discover the wider region, so I'll add some links in the description you may want to check out. On our right is the former 16th century old forge, as we pass the brewery cottages on our left. And then there's the historic 16th century General Wolfe Inn, that's now a private house. And then we come to Pitt's Cottage, which a blue plaque describes as 12th century, but historic England describe as 16th century or earlier. Either way, William Pitt, British Prime Minister, lived here. On the opposite side of the road is Brook Cottage, again dating from the 16th century or earlier. Flowing in front of it is the early stages of the River Darent, which we caught up with in our Darent Valley road trip. We're going to amble back to town now because there's a couple more things I want to show you. The first is the Real Ale Way, a micropub that looks very tempting, and it's giving me another reason to return to Westerham. What about you? Are you tempted to visit Westerham? Please leave us a comment, we'd love to know. Now we're making our way back towards Westerham Green. Actually, we're making our way back to the car. We parked in the town car park, just past Quebec House, and the great thing is that at the time of recording, the first 3 hours are free. Parking in town is possible, but it can be challenging. Anyway, the reason to bring you here is the view over the Weald from St. Peter and St. Paul's Church. A big thanks to the local gentleman who pointed this out. Anyway, it's now time to bring this video to an end. Don't forget to check out the road trip. Thanks so much for watching. Stay safe, stay well, and happy travels.